2.77 acres. Independent India's most controversial court case, the Babri Masjid land dispute, is about just this much land, around two football fields. But what is the dispute over these 2.77 acres that a five-judge bench of the Supreme Court is set to declare its verdict on? Who are the claimants? And what parts of the land are they claiming? This is what the disputed site looks like. This is where the Babri Masjid stood before it was demolished on 6th December 1992. Apart from the three domes, there's a raised platform structure called the Ram Chabutra, another two structures called the Sita Rasoi and Bhandar, and gates known as Hanuman Dwar and Sihadwar. But to understand the dispute itself, we need to travel back to 1885. In 1885, Mahant Raghubir Das wanted to build a temple at the Ram Chabutra. The Ram Chabutra was said to be built in 1855 and was worshipped as Lord Ram's birthplace. But Raghubir Das was refused permission to build a temple by British India's Faizabad District Court. Let's now move forward around 65 years to 1949. On the night of 22nd to 23rd December 1949, idols of Ram, Sita and Lakshman were placed inside the Babri Masjid, under the central dome. This was done by a priest called Abhiram Das and a group of local sadhus. They offered prayers to the statue, right there under the central dome. Prime Minister Jawaharlal Nehru wrote to Govind Ballabh Pant, the then Chief Minister of United Provinces. But the idols inside the mosque weren't removed. A few days later, on 29th December 1949, Faizabad District Court declared the area a disputed site and it was locked up. In 1959, the Nirmohi Akhada filed a claim, saying that they had been managing the site and praying there to Lord Ram for several centuries. In 1961, the Sunni Central Waqf Board also staked a claim. They said that the land was owned by them, since it was granted to them as Waqf property by the Mughals. While litigation was still underway, 1986 brought a major twist to the history of the Babri Masjid site. 1986. The locks to the disputed site were broken on the orders of Faizabad District Judge. 2 days later, a group of Muslim lawyers petitioned the Allahabad High Court against the opening of the locks. In response, the judge ordered that status quo be maintained. But the opening of the locks made Babri Masjid and the Ram Janmabhoomi dispute into a national issue. 1989. In 1989, another party filed a claim to the land, Ram Lalla Virajman or Lord Ram's idol, arguing that its resting place at the Babri Masjid was Lord Ram's birthplace. Those representing Ram Lalla said that the entire 2.77 acres was Lord Ram's Janmabhoomi and had been a site of worship since time immemorial. In August 1989, the Allahabad High Court combined all of these cases and decided to hear them. But politically, the Ram Janmabhoomi movement was gaining strength, culminating in the Babri Masjid demolition in 1992. On the morning of 6th December 1992, Babri Masjid was surrounded by 1.5 lakh karsevaks or volunteers. At the same time, Mahant Satyendra Das, helped by a few other people, shifted the three idols of Ram, Sita and Lakshman that had been installed under the central dome since 1949. The idols were shifted to this nearby shelter or chabutra within the 2.7 acre complex. By the evening of 6th December, the karsevaks had demolished the Babri Masjid. After the demolition, leaders of the Vishwa Hindu Parishad formed the Ram Janmabhoomi Nyas, which bought 42 acres of the land around the disputed site. In 1993, the central government acquired 67 acres of land around the disputed site, including the 42 acres acquired by Ram Janmabhoomi Nyas. Time to move forward again. Another 17 years. 2010. After years of hearing, the Allahabad High Court delivered a judgment on the case on 30th September 2010. The judgment divided the disputed 2.77 acres of land among three parties, Nirmohi Akhada, Ram Lalla Virajman and the Sunni Waqf Board. According to the judgment, the three central domes were allotted to Ram Lalla Virajman. The court said that Ram Lalla and Ram Janbhumi had rights to the land because of the belief that this was the birthplace of Lord Ram. Ram Chabutra, Sita Rasoi and Bhandar were given to Nirmohi Akhada. Sunni Waqf Board was to be allotted one-third of the remaining land. The court assured them that a portion of the land acquired by the government in 1993 could be used to ensure that they got their share. None of the parties in the case had asked for a partition of the land. And so, not surprisingly, none were happy with the High Court judgment. Appeals were filed in the Supreme Court, and a judgment in the case was reserved in October 2019. The Supreme Court's verdict, delivered by a 5-judge bench, could be the final chapter in the long and complex history of arguably the most important court case in independent India's history. And all eyes will be on those 2.77 acres of land in Ayodhya.